Hi guys, hope you are doing good. We are here today to discuss photography, yes, of course, but what in that? 5 steps to improve your photography process. Before that, let me ask you a question. Have you heard a term called director, movie director, director of photography, managing director? I'm sure that you would have heard this term, right? Now, what does a director do? Take in the case of an organization, there is a managing director. What do they do? Decision making, final decision making, whether it has to go in this way or this way, who decides? The director decides. Now, when you are doing photography, do you have similar kind of situation? Direction, whether I should do this or that? There are 5 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Simple thing, but I think if you are able to follow this particular 5 steps, I'm sure that you will be able to make better result with your photography. If you ask any famous photographers, do you do decision making while clicking? They will say, yeah, of course, yes. What are the things that runs in your mind while before clicking? They will say many things, a lot of things. We are here to discuss that. Like the famous photographer Ansel Adams, he said once, right, that you don't take a photograph, you make it. So if you really want to make something, you have to have a decision making capability. Now to do that, we are here, this 5 steps will help you. 1, we will count this 5 steps as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with 5 fingers. The small one, goal. In photography, we call it as pre-visualization. Before even taking the camera, you have to know what is that I am trying to achieve. Have you seen people taking with mobile the same scene, tuck, 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 tuck? I don't know, 4, 5, 6 images, same thing they take. It is because of our technology convenience, we tend to become like that. And without even thinking, what is that I want to achieve, you click. I think you must avoid that. Now onwards, before clicking, think what is that you want. Have a pre-visual in your mind, and at least a vague visual will do. But think. Then comes to the step number 2. So first, what is that? The final image as pre-visualization. We call it as goal, okay? Second, ring finger. If you want to put a ring, technically it is to be right? If the ring is bigger or smaller than the size of your finger, it will not fit. So technically it has to be right. What is technically in photography when you say? Your shutter speed, aperture, ISO, white balance, all these things, technically what you set in the camera should be right as per your final image visualized. Agreed? So you got 2 steps. Third step, aesthetically it has to be appealing. Let's take an example. If you are shooting a family portrait, so you already visualize that this is the kind of output I want. So you are clear that this is the way I want. To get that, you know technically what should be the depth of field, what should be the aperture, what should be the ISO, white balance, everything you know. Okay, fine, you said that as well. If the picture doesn't have a color harmony, it doesn't have a right composition and a kind of drama lighting, you lost it. Technically, you are right. But if the picture doesn't have aesthetics, your photography is not going to be that great. Make it aesthetically appealing, the middle finger, aesthetics. Index finger. This is for you to click. This is also a finger for attitude, isn't it? Now, if you don't have a right attitude towards your subjects, towards the people in the crew and the set, you may end up not having a great result. Having a right attitude and clicking with that kind of attitude will make, trust me, will make better pictures. So this finger is for you to click with the right attitude. Thumb, the most important, right? If you show like this, what does it mean? Like, dislike. What is like and dislike? It's basically an evaluation. You like something because you evaluated it, whether it's good or bad. How many of you check your image with an expert or somebody who knows that subject, whether this picture is good or bad? Try to do that. Have a mentor or ask someone who is experienced in that. Try to find the mistakes. If you find the mistakes in that picture, you will be able to solve it in the subsequent shoot. You will improve. Evaluation, the 5th thing. So So five things we have. One, begin with end in mind, like Stephen Covey said. What is that you wanted to achieve? Goal. That is the first. Second, technically right. Remember the ring, technically. Technically, you have to set it right. Third, aesthetically, it has to be appealing. Fourth, click with the right attitude. Fifth, evaluate. I think with this five steps methodology, you will be able to take a better decision, and I'm sure that your photography will improve. All these five steps, whatever I said, we are going to have some practical scenarios explaining it, how each step should be done in the coming episode. So stay tuned, you will be able to learn something really good. Thank you guys.